Hello students, good afternoon. Again today I am going to start the topic for class 8 and 9. I am going to start the next chapter, that is chapter 16, and chapter name is Fundamental of QVC. Chapter name is Fundamental of QVC. Now topic is variable. Student, here I have written let A equal to 5 and B equal to 6 and n dollar equal to RAM. What it is? It is the name of variable. Name of variables. What actually is a variable? What is variable? Student, you know that? You are going to use the QVC programming language. For what purpose? For writing the program to perform the certain calculation. You are going to write a QVC program. And to perform the certain calculation, you need some numbers, you need some data. And on the basis of that data, on the basis of that number, certain calculation will be performed. For example, a student, suppose you are going to calculate the interest amount for the customer. Then to calculate the interest amount for the customer, you need the data, that is the principal amount, that is the time, and that is the rate. So on the basis of these three, principal amount, time and rate, interest amount and total amount is calculated. Suppose you have a requirement. Suppose to calculate the marksheet, To calculate the marksheet of a student, you need some data. That is the marks of all the subjects. That is math mark, science mark, Nepali mark, English mark, computer mark, like that. You need the mark of all the 8 subjects, then the total mark, percentage and division will be calculated. I mean to say that you need some number. You need some data to perform the certain calculation. Without data, without number, it is impossible to perform the any calculation. Then, how to keep the data? How to take a number? You can take a number by the help of variables that are A, B, and N. These are the variables. By the help of variables, we are going to take data for certain calculations. Not technically, I want to tell that variable is like a pocket. This is the pocket. In the pocket, I am going to keep something for the future reference. By the help of pocket, we are going to keep something for the future reference. In the same way, by the help of variables, we are going to keep the constant in again for certain calculation. Technically, what is variable? Variable, it is an entity that allows to keep the constant in the program for certain calculation. It is an entity, variable, this is A, B, and M, they are the variable. It is an entity which is used to keep the constant in the program for certain calculation. Student, you can tell, you A may have a variable, kina panchuga? Kina avunam korena? Why is not as variable? Mean to say that, yeah, student, simply see here, suppose I am going to write here very small program, let A equal to 5. This print a statement, print A, now let A equal to A plus 1, and then print A. What is happening? See now, this is a program, and this program is executed, it gives the result in output window. This is the output window. Here A equal to 5, I told you A is the variable, and the value is 5. I'm going to prove why it is not as variable. The value of A is 5, print A, the print statement executed, it prints the value of A in the output window, that is 5. Okay, student. Our dhyan dena uska let A equal to A plus 1. The A to value kaisa 5. 5 plus 1 equal to 6. Our A to value change diya le. Print statement is going to print A out of 6. What is happening?
एक बार यहां समाप्त 5 किलो आफ्टर द एग्जीक्यूशन ऑफ दिस स्टेटमेंट द वैल्यू बिकम्स 6 दैट इज चेंज्ड द वेरी एबल टू वैरी द वैल्यू मींस यूजर कैन चेंज द वैल्यू ऑफ वेरिएबल ड्यूरिंग द प्रोग्राम एग्जीक्यूशन एज पर द रिक्वायरमेंट यू कैन जस्ट वी हैव चेंज एक बार पास किया तो यहां 6 हो जाएगा 6 हो जाएगा We have changed the value of variable so that its name is variable. Able to vary the value. User can change as per the requirement. User can change the value of variable. Okay, students. So that its name is variable. Its name is variable. What is variable? Just I told you, it is an entity which is used. It is an entity which is used to keep the constant in the program for certain calculation. The value of variable can be changed during the program execution. QVC provides basic two types of variable, that is numeric variable, string variable. Numeric variable, a variable which is used to store the number, a variable which is used to store the number, that is a combination of digits from 0 to 9. So that is correct, a equal to 5. The 5 is the number that stores to the a, so that a is a numeric variable. Here, suppose let b equal to 1, 2, 3.45. This is also the number, so that b is also known as the numeric variable. Numeric variable is used to store the number. Numeric variable is used to store the number. That is the combination of digits from 0 to 9. User can store the number that is a combination of 0 to 9. User can store the integer number, user can store the fractional number. Yaha 5 is the integer number without point value. Yaha 1 to 3.45, this is the fractional number, real number. Numeric variable is a variable which is used to store the number which is the combination of digits from 0 to 9. It can store the positive number or it can store the negative number. Right, student? Now, the string variable. The string variable is a variable which is used to store the string constant. What is a string constant? Here, student, writing let n dollar equal to RAM. So these are the numbers. No, these are the alphabets. These are the combination of alphabets from A to B. What is a string constant? A string constant is a combination of alphabet, numbers, and any other special symbol that has kept in the double quotes. Is known as a string constant. A string variable stores the string constant and which is declared. It is declared by the help of dollar sign. Here n ko agar ke sir, this is a dollar. This dollar sign is used to declare the string variable, and a string variable is used to store the string constant. That is the combination of alphabet from A to B. Correct explaining? Now, the numeric variable is further divided in three types. That is, number one, integer variable. Number two, single precision variable. And double precision variable. These are the types of numeric variable. Our student, what they are? What is the integer variable? What is the single precision variable and what is the double precision variable? Integer variable. Student, let us understand now. Suppose you are going to make a meaningful program such as result sheet of a student.
Result sheet of a student,
you have seen unik pani vidyarthi ko roll number decimal ma huncha ta
1.5 huncha
1.6 huncha
2.4 huncha
hudaina always some data some number is you have to take in the form of integer. That is the student roll number.
The student
roll number is always integer. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, no point value, no decimal. Then how to take a such type of data? You can take a such type of data by the help of integer variable. And how to declare the integer variable, student?
Here, writing date. Let's suppose R percentage. R percentage equal to 15.
Here percentage is the signs.
Percentage is the sign which is used to declare the integer variable.
Yaha percentage hatayi jo, then R becomes the unique variable. And when we have added the percentage, R becomes integer variable.
What is integer variable?
Integer variable is declared.
Integer variable is declared by the help of percentage sign.
It is used to store the integer constant that must not have any kind of fractional value. Means 15 point suppose 4.5, it is a wrong number. Matlab point wala value nidai na ki galat ho, that is the wrong data. So that if you have a requirement to take only the integer data, you have to declare the integer variable, and integer variable is declared by the percentage sign.
Percentage, suppose 1, 2, 4.
1, 2, 4, this is also the integer.
What is integer variable?
Integer variable is declared. Integer variable is declared by the help of percentage sign. It allocates the 2 bytes memory in the computer. It is used to store the integer constant that must not have any kind of fractional data, decimal data. It is used to store the student roll number. It is used to store the student account number. It is used to store the mobile number. Kuni pani mobile number decimal ma huncha? Kuni pani account number decimal ma huncha?
No.
So if you have a requirement to keep a such kind of data, you have to declare the integer variable. An integer variable is declared by the percentage sign. Right, student?
Now,
what is single precision variable?
Suppose writing
here name
a exclamation equal to 1, 2, 3.
Formally 1, 2, 3.
Our heroes 1, 2, 3 matre dekho. After your point here,
0, 0 complete.
Kale thapcha ki basically thapcha.
Without exclamation sign. Exclamation sign is used to declare the single precision variable.
यहाँ a मा जो हटाई तो उसे नंबर बने को तो a becomes the numeric variable. और अब इसमें exclamation sign था कि जो then a becomes the single precision variable.
Mean to say that
single precision variable is declared by the help of exclamation sign.
It is used to store the real number. It is used to store the fractional number for accurate calculation.
Again, sunos. Single precision variable
is declared by the help of exclamation sign.
It allocates the 4 bytes memory.
It is used to store fractional number, real number.
Suppose here 1, 2, 3.
यहाँ 1, 2, 3 मार हमें लेकिन decimal value दिए तो ठीक है ना आपने 0, 0 कर दिया.
Suppose p exclamation equal to 1, 4, 5, 1, 4, 6.
Correct number, it is correct. Matlab, when you are going to do the real calculation, financial calculation, statistical calculation, paisa, rupaya calculation, if you want to do, in that case you have to declare single precision variable, and that is declared by the help of exclamation sign. Correct? Now double precision variable.
And in a string, I am going to write here, let's suppose B has equal to 1, 2, 4, 5, 9, 4, 6.
It is correct statement. What have you seen? B has sign. यहाँ percentage था, then exclamation था, then hash sign.
The double precision variable, is declared by the help of hash sign. It allocates the 8 bytes memory. It is used to store the real number, fractional number, like single precision variable, But the strain, the capacity of double precision variable is double than the capacity of single precision. Matlab, you have a requirement to store the very large number, billions ma value rakhnu cha. And the capacity of single precision variable is not allowed. In that case, double precision variable is declared to store such a big number in a computer system for the real life, for the accurate calculation. Single precision variable and double precision variable both are used to store float. Both are used to store decimal number, float number. But the difference is that the capacity of double precision variable is double than the capacity of single precision variable. Right, student? Clear now? Okay, now next topic is constraint. Constraint. Numeric constraint. String constraint. Our string. Here, let us start from the example. I am writing here let a equal to 5. Let b equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Writing let r dollar equal to theta. Let ad dollar equal to jnk 5. Let event dollar equal to sita 123 at the rate yahoo dot gmail dot com. What is that constant? Student, constant is a fixed entity that cannot be changed during the program execution. Users are not allowed, nobody has allowed to change the meaning of constant. Constant is a fixed entity that cannot be changed during the program execution. Like this tonight, I just told you, there are two types of constant, numeric constant, string constant. What is the numeric constant? A numeric constant is a combination of digits. Numeric constant is a combination of digits from 0 to 9. It's known as numeric constant. Either you can keep positive number or either you can keep negative number. For example, here 10, a equal to 5. This 5 is known as numeric constant. B equal to minus 52, minus 123.456. They both are known as numeric constant because it is the combination of digits from 0 to 9. That cannot be changed during the program execution. Numeric constant is the combination of digits. It is the combination of digits from 0 to 9. That may be the positive or negative number that cannot be changed. It is a fixed notation. It is known as numeric constant. String constant, I told you, string constant is the combination of alphabet, numbers or any other special symbol that has kept inside the double quotes is known as a string constant. For example, here, Sita, what is this? It is a combination of alphabet. It is a string constant. What is this? JK-5. This is the number. It is the combination of alphabet and numbers that is kept inside the double quotes, string constant. What is this? Here Sita means alphabet, number, here at the rate is special symbol, yahoo.com special symbols. All are mixing there. String constant is the combination of alphabet, numbers, or any other special symbol that has kept inside the double quotes is known as a string constant. It's known as the string constant. Correct, student? Now, next topic I am going to start, that is operator. Operator. Arithmetic operator. Rational operator. And logical operator. Logical operator. Here student, let A equal to 5, let B equal to 6, C equal to A plus B. In this example, what have you understood? A, B and C, they are known as the variable. Which type of variable? Numeric variable. Now student, equal to, this is the equal to and plus, they are known as operator. Operator. What is this? What is the function of this operator? What is the operator? What is the function of operator? Operator is a symbol. Operator is a sign symbol which is used to perform the calculation between the operands. Operators are symbols. Operators are symbols which are used to perform the certain calculation between the operands. Here student, A ko wali ka is 5 plus C, B ko wali ka is 6. Yo 5 ko 6 ko beech ma jo plus ke karta operation karne ka karta. जस्ते डॉक्टर ने पेशेंट लाइक ऑपरेशन करसन जस्ते प्लस ने 5 और 6 को बीच में ऑपरेशन करने का करसन तो ऑपरेशन करने रिजल्ट दिस एरर है तो प्लस के छ ऑपरेटर छ इसको काम के छ सर्किट कैलकुलेशन ऑपरेटर्स आर सिंबल्स दैट आर यूज्ड टू परफॉर्म द सर्टेन कैलकुलेशन बिटवीन द ऑपरेंड्स यहां ए अभी के छ दे आर नॉट एज ऑपरेंड्स They are known as operands. Operators are symbols. Operators are symbols that are used to perform the certain calculation between the operands. Or constant. Or constant. Student, यहाँ arrows equal to को क्या काम था? The role, the function of all the operators are fixed. Equal to क्या काम था? It is used to assign the value from right to left. It is used to assign the value from right to left. Plus ko kya kaam tha? It is used to perform the addition between the two numbers. The role of the function of all the operators are significant. Operators are symbols that are used to perform the certain calculation between the operands. Without operator, calculation is impossible. User cannot perform any kind of calculation. KBC provides three types of operator: arithmetic operator, relational operator, logical operator. What is arithmetic operator? Student, arithmetic operator is used to perform the all types of mathematical calculation. What are the mathematical calculation you are doing in the mathematics?
that all types of mathematical calculations can perform by the help of arithmetic operator using the QBasic by writing the word game. Using the QBasic by writing the word game. Arithmetic operators contain the rich collection of symbols. Arithmetic operators contains the rich collection of symbols, that is plus, that is minus, that is star, that is division, that is forward division, that is more, and last is gap. So more is here. This is the basic arithmetic operators that I have written. These arithmetic operators are used to perform the all types of mathematical calculation by writing the program QBasic. Suppose you have a requirement to do the addition, plus symbol to use. Requirement to do the subtraction, minus symbol to use. Requirement to do the multiplication, then a star sign is used. Okay, now these are the difficult. Let us see now. Suppose writing let a equal to 5, let b equal to 2, writing c equal to a divided by b. This is the backward slash, division slash. A divided by B, A equivalence of 5, B equivalence of 2. 5 is going to be divided by 2, that is 5 divided by 2, 2 to the 4, remainder 1, 1, 0, 2, 5, 3. So this division operator is used to return the percent value. What is the percent value? 2.5. What is the percent value? 2.5, so that you will get the division 2.5. Now students, see now, suppose writing D equal to A forward slash B. A ko value nahi tha, 5 forward slash B ko value nahi tha, 2. See the difference, both are the division operator, both are used to divide the number. See the difference, A equal to 5 cha, B equal to 2 cha. 5 is going to be divided by 2, this division operator. Forward slash division operator is used to return the percent value, that is 2.5. Thereof, it is also known as integer division operator. It is used to return only the integer part of a percent value, that is 2.1. Yahan kisma, it returns the real, it returns the actual percent value, that is 2.5. But this division operator is known as integer division operator. It is used to return only the integer part of a percent value, that is 2.1. That is 2.1. That is the difference between backward slash and forward slash. Right? Our student, what is mode? Mode ke sada, our mode ko kesma. Mode ko kesma, suppose writing C equal to A mod B. What is the value of A? 5 mod B ko value is 2. B ko value is 2. Now, Andinos, mode is the operator that divides the number, and when the number is not divisible, it returns the remainder value. When the number is not divisible, it returns the remainder value, so that 5 lies 2 there. So 2 to 4, 1. Our 1 to the divisible sign. 1 to the divisible sign, then it returns the remainder value, that is 1. Your percent value, your remainder value. Mode operator, it is an arithmetic operator. It is an arithmetic operator which is used to divide the number, and when the number is not divisible, it returns the remainder value, that is 1. Result kya hai? 1. Suppose writing here b equal to 4 mod 2. So, 4 like 2 will divide by 7. 2 to the 4, the remainder value comes here 0, so that we will get the result 0. Like this way? Your remainder value. Correct now? Okay. Next is this cap sign, that is caret sign. A equal to 5. I am writing let suppose b equal to a cap sign 2. Your cap sign ka matlab the power of given number. Isko matlab hai a ko power 2, a ko value kaisa 5 ko power 2, that is 25. This cap sign is used to find the power of given number. Yahan a square kar diyo, a ko value 5 kiyo, 5 ko square, that is 25. Suppose the story is now writing be equal to 25 cap 0.5 Thank you very much for playing.